So please take a look at the screen and students, you also just see here, right? We starting off from last week we had discussed imperative sentences. Today we'll do interrogative. Okay. Now what are interrogative sentences here? These are the sentences that ask what questions, right? And when we change from direct to indirect, our purpose is that we have to change the sentence into a statement. We change it into a assertive statement, whether it is negative or positive, depending upon the kind of question that we have. Now, when we do questions here, one thing that we have to remember when we, you know, like change it from the direct to the indirect form and before the reported speech, right? It is not introduced by that. Remember this. Okay. So we have if, whether, right, asked and inquired. Yes. And our WH words, they remain the same, right? What, who, where, how. All this, so like, and accordingly, the changes would be there. So can would become could. Can you help me? Right? Will you do this work for me? Would you do this work for me? Right? So automatically the changes would be made. So let's look at it over here. Like, yes. So as I told you, yeah. So we introduce with if or whether, right? And asked, inquire. WH will remain the same. Must. May will become might. Will, would. Shall, should. Must will become had to, right? Or would have to. And in some cases, when it is like, something which is there, a law, right? Must wear a helmet. It will remain as such, okay? Right, so these are the things here. And once again, very important thing, you know, we have a question mark at the end of an interrogative sentence. Yes, we'll remove this also. What will it become? It'll become, of course, it'll be a full stop. We remove the inverted commas. We remove the question mark. So it becomes a simple statement. So if you don't do that, if at the end of the sentence, you see that a question mark is there, or that is there, these are the things you have to identify. Okay. So when you do your multiple choice questions, these are little things that you have to keep in mind. Now here, let us look at the examples. Have you found the page? Yes. Those here in the classroom, offline classes here, the students, sorry. What? And those who are at home, of course, always at an advantage because I am there with you sharing the screen. He said to her, shall I accompany you to Agra? The sentence is there. He said to her, shall I accompany you to Agra? 262, the C. Show me the book, I'll find the page for you. No, it is not here. It is 272. Open to page 272, those of you have the books, and those who are at home can look at the screen, okay? Hmm? You've done this? Okay, fine, right. So we have to discuss this at least, no? He asked her if he would or should accompany her to Agra. Right, so pronoun, see the things that we have to remember when we change narration. Other things remain the same. That is the change of tense and the change of pronoun, the change of place, position, time. All these rules would be the same, but what we have to remember, that is not used. We introduce with if or whether, asked, inquired, or simply what, where, how, why, when. Okay, she said to him, had I been absenting myself from school for a month? It's already there, had. What would it be? She said to him, she asked him, if she had been absenting, myself would become herself from school for a month. Okay, so you can just go through these examples. He said to us, has she been spinning? See, when you have here, you know, all these interrogative, your pronouns are there and how it has to be done. I said to her, will you have ironed your clothes? If she would have. Now, all of you, please turn to the next page where the multiple choices are there. Let me show you which one we're going to do. It is here. No, I'll show you where the questions are. No, I have the screen with me. Page 284. You have the book over there. Everybody has the book. Page 284. All of you, look at it. These ones we have done. Where are you going? I'm going to the airport. Why are you going there? We've done this. It's solved in your book. Let me see the next one. Why are you late, Sam? I missed the school bus. You should done this. Wait. Let's see the next one also. Page 285. Open to that. The world will end tomorrow. Who told you this? I have heard your father say so. Let's just go through it. Since we've opened them, the world will end tomorrow. Ravi said that. Look at the options. The world. See all the things that you have to change. Will become. Tomorrow will become. The next day. Which is the correct option then? First one. The world would end. Page 285. Which page is it, Hardik?
285.
Yeah, found it?
Yeah.
Fifth one. Have you all found? Yes. So at home, it's so easy. Ma'am is sharing the screen. You just have to look at it and do nothing. Isn't it? Right. So Ravi said the world would end the next day. Who told you this? Who told you this? Shankar asked him. Yes. And see here, look at the options there. There's a question mark also. There's a question mark also. Who had told him that? Actually, the question mark should not be there. So please remember this. And if both options are there, one with a question mark, one without the question mark, you will choose the option without the question mark. Because the purpose of changing from direct to indirect, the purpose from changing from an interrogative is to make it into a assertive sentence. So will it be assertive if the question mark is there? So this is a wrong thing, you know, like it's a printing error, I suppose so. Okay. Shankar asked him, I have heard your father say so. Come on, first do it yourself, then look for the correct answer. Shankar, not like this. Then Ravi replied that, I have heard. He had heard his father say so. Have is there, no? Yes? Now, where are you going now? Just a minute. Said, it will be said only, not say so, it will be said, right? I've heard your father say so, right? Say that. Next is, where are you going now? I am going to look after my grandfather. What has happened to him? He has been suffering. Now here, you know, like when you get these kind of sentences, it's very easy for us that see there are four dialogues. And we have to remember to fill in the blanks of each one. Sometimes what happens, we get a sentence which has two parts. Which has two parts there, right? We have to do both the parts. Sometimes what happens, we forget the second blank. And so it is generally a common error. So you have to remember that if I have to do, then if a sentence has two parts, then we have to do both of them. Look at this one now. Where are you going now? I am going to look after my grandfather. What has happened to him? He has been suffering from high fever. Okay. So Kumar asked Gulab. Where was he going then? I am going to look after my grandfather. Gulab replied that.
He was going to look after his grandfather.
Which option is that? The second one. He was going to look after his grandfather. What has happened to him? Why are others not speaking up? I can see Hardik. I can hear Hardik's voice. Yes, Shantanu? Find the answers and let me know. He's done it. And what about, then Hardik is going to keep quiet. Everyone is done. I'm not getting the responses from everyone. Okay. Kumar further asked him, yes, replied that A, B, C. What has happened to him? What had happened to him? Ashwari, why are you late today? Sir, I missed my bus. Take care in future. Yes, where is that option? Now, all of you here at home, let me see. I have other exercise for you all. You can go through that. Let's see. So in your revision, naturally, it is going to be a bigger responsibility. Now, this one you have not done. Okay. And let me see here. All of you, look at this. Now, this is a new one. This is not from your book. I have taken it from elsewhere. Look at the screen if you can give me the answer. And yes, to make things easier for you all, I'll be sharing this PDF with you in the group also, so that you can go through it before our lecture. Okay, so you'll have the questions with you. That is the only purpose of this. I hope you can read. You may think it is funny, but I can't. Then why should I treat your eyes? I believe illiterate too need eyes to see. How strange. Okay, yes, come on. This is a dialogue between the doctor and the patient. Now look at the blanks here. I hope you can read. The doctor told the patient. I hope you can. Is this an interrogative sentence? No, this is an assertive sentence, so you can use that. Yes, the doctor told the patient that he hoped he could read. Simple as that. This is from another book which I'm sharing. Okay, so I'll be sharing the PDF with you all. The patient said, you may think it is funny, but I can't. Write it down, those of you, write down the sentence. You may think it is funny, but I can't. Change it. You can write. Write down then. You may, Mehul does not do any work at all. He's so lazy. You may think it is funny, but I can't. Now here, this is a sentence with two parts. Like I told you, so we have to do both the parts. Yes. What is the correct answer? The patient said that you may think it is funny, but I can't. Please write it down. You may think it is funny, but I can't. Let's find the answer. And of course, here in these grammar sheets that I have added all the kind of grammar questions that you can get, like from narration, you can get gap filling. Okay, editing is not there. So our main focus is, yes, our narration is there, our gap filling is there, and subject verb agreement. Okay, so subject verb agreement you could get as rewrite it correctly. Right, an incorrect sentence is there, and you have to find the correct one. Okay, right. Yes, what, how are you going to write it? What is the answer? The patient said that he might think it was funny, but he could not. You have to look over here. Look, the sentence is there. Can you change it for me, please? Jaya? I've given the answer already. Then why should I treat your eyes? Write down. Then why should I treat your eyes? So the doctor asked the patient. The doctor asked the patient. Then why should I treat your eyes? Why? Why will it remain as such? Yes? Why? Yes, he should treat his eyes. Then, of course, then will also be added. Why should he then treat his eyes? The patient replied, or I believe illiterate too need eyes to see. Simple. I believe illiterates too need eyes to see. It's not only literate people, they need eyes to see because they have to read. Our basic purpose is that, yeah, eyes, we can see. But illiterates, if they can't differentiate the letters, so they don't know how to read and write, that is a big loss for them. Right? So it is that illiterates too need eyes to see. Now look at this. This is one form of questions that you might get next year also. Yes, this is also a narration that I have. This is a dialogue completion by choosing the correct option. Okay. So let's see these kinds of questions here. Then we have, yes, I have, we have the option here. Jay said Vipul takes exercise daily. So if it has been changed, right, into narration, you have to choose the correct answer. So these are the different kinds of maybe questions that you will be getting. So don't worry, we are sharing with you and you will get an idea. Okay. Now look at this. Where can we meet tomorrow? To the next one. Yes, online students, come on, let me hear your responses. Where can we meet tomorrow? I may not be able to meet you tomorrow. Are you going to be busy? Yes, I will be traveling tomorrow. Anoop asked Anil, where can we meet tomorrow? This is a PDF that I'm sharing. Screen sharing that I'm doing. It's not there in your book. Where can we meet tomorrow? Yes? Anoop asked Anil. I can't. I wish there was. Where can we meet tomorrow? How would we change this? Anoop asked Anil, where could they? Yes? Please change this. Yeah, let me write it for you all. It's quite difficult, you know, making you people also do. I mean, I have to share. I'll be sharing the screen now, most of it, especially for grammar period. Right? So for literature and writing, it's okay. I'll be doing it here. But when it comes to grammar, because most of you don't have the books, then I'll be sharing the screen. Okay? So the only thing is that I'll share it a day in advance and you write the answers. I mean, discuss them in the class. That's the only option. Yes? So where can we meet tomorrow? How are we going to change this? Yes, Vansh? Give me the answer. I've given you here. Like Anoop asked Anil. Please complete it. This is your sentence. How do we change from direct and indirect? This is an interrogative sentence. What are the things we have to keep in mind? What are the things? Yes, it's WH. Then what will come here? Where? Okay. Can will become? Could? We will become? Meet? Tomorrow? The next day or the following day? Do I put a question mark in the end? No. So can you do this? Do you remember you did in class 8? I don't know what you did in class 9. Okay. So I'm dealing with in class 10. Let's see. Done? Okay, fine. Now let's do the next part. I may not be able to meet you tomorrow. Atul replied, it's Anoop and Atul. Okay, so Anil replied, write down, I may not be able to meet you tomorrow. How are you going to change this? I may not be able to meet you tomorrow. Write down the sentence. Mehal, why are you not writing? Get up and go over there. Go there. I may not be able to meet you tomorrow. Let me see how, what the online students are responding. Yes? Yeah. Yes. That can come over here in this sentence. Yes. That he might not be able to meet him the next day or the following day. Fine. Okay. Next. Are you going to be busy? Anoop asked Anil. Are you going to be busy? How do we change this? If or whether. Write down and show me first. Write down. Then we'll match our answers with the options given. Are you going to be busy? Yes, if or whether. Then we use here for the yes or no questions, isn't it? Right? If he was going to be busy. What is that? So not much of a change. Next is, Atul replied, yes. Now here, once again, yes. I will be traveling tomorrow. Yes. Now here, remember, as I said, two parts. One part is this, and this is the other one. Right? Very good. And yes, Amripa, that he replied, yes is in the affirmative. Right? Same. Okay. That I will be traveling tomorrow. That he, yes, he has said that. And added that he would be traveling the next day. Yes, students at home, is it clear to you? Yes or no? Give me a yes or no. Yeah. So, can you see the screen? I hope that I mean, you know, like maybe what this whole time I've been talking and the screen has not been visible. Have you got the test done? No, I have not. Get them done today itself. It's not only your tests, right? There are other tests also. Why? Yeah, Monday no test.
Oh, yes.
Right. Have you got the test done? Have you got the test done? No, I just have to share a link. It's no big problem for me. I can do it. So I think it's been a long time since we got a day off. Let's enjoy the day off, isn't it? Yeah. Have you got the test done? So the doctor and it is what? Will you keep quiet? All this is coming in the recording. All this is being recorded. What all comments you're passing by? How sad. Have you got the test done? So the doctor asked Karan, what? How are you going to change it? Yes. Whether he had got the test done. Very nice. Then, of course, he's like you, and he replied. Yes. Right. So he replied in the negative that he had not. Okay. Then the doctor said, get them done today. Yes. So the doctor asked him to get them done today means that day. Okay, fine. So please hear what you have to do when it comes to narration. You have to solve it, then find out the correct answer. And because you know about the rules, you have had enough practice, it should be easy for you to identify. Okay, right. So we'll continue with our revision tomorrow on Monday. That is...